What is up? Welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Flippinstoop. I said I was going to make a follow-up video on the items we found at the brain fart, right? We went to a flea market anyways this morning, found some really cool items, and if you stick around to the end, I think I found a couple prizes that I'll show you guys. You guys let me know what you think on them. First of all, I got a story though. So I get back from doing our shopping, taking my fiance, or going to the gym, the video I made before I went to the gym, get off Rex. I went, did my running, come back home, go downstairs to get ready to pull this stuff up, take a video, show you guys what I got, right? Here in Michigan, we have the worst basements possible, right? And I walked downstairs to like an inch flood across the basement floor in my work zone. Yes, the majority of my boxes are up on water, but one of them was not.
What a headache, right?
Just a headache. So that's what I came home to. But anyways, let's jump into some of the items I found. Now, mind you, I told you, I said it in my prior video, when we went in here, it was in a school. So in this school, they scramble your phone service so the kids can't use their phone throughout school, whatever, right? Whatever that was, I couldn't look any of these items up, so I had no clue. And I went outside of my niche, and I'm going to show you guys some of them items. I think Victor in the Facebook group will be happy with me with two of the items I found, maybe three of them. I made a video a while back ago about a whole tote of Hot Wheel cars from the 70s to the 90s. Went to go get them the next day, and they were all sold out, right? So, snooze you lose, right? All right, so let's jump in. First, now this clothes, there's nothing really super special about the clothing. These are brands, though, and some items that I will pick up all the time. We picked up a North Face fleece, a black one, for $2.50. Just a regular full zip fleece. Next one is Abercrombie cropped, like corduroy blazer, top, whatever you want to call it. Corduroy is there right now. It's a size small, maroon. I picked this up for $2.50. I have no doubts in my mind that will sell pretty fast. Second thing is I usually don't pick up these jeans. And they had them marked for $10 a piece. You can see the sticker here, $10 a piece. I usually don't pick up the name brand Arizona. But right now, they're boot cut. They're brand new. I got them both for 10 bucks, so I paid 5 bucks a piece. The price tag on them is still $44. I do sell Arizona jeans. I just usually don't pay for them. I usually sell them when they're free, right? So I picked these up for a total of 10 bucks. MSRP would be $88 on the both of them. Of course, we're not going to get $88 out of them. But I still think for them being brand new, bootleg, I should be able to still sell them for at least $23, $24 a piece. Let's see what else I found. American Eagle. A lot of people pass these up, but I don't pass them up. I pass them if they're in a thrift store and they want $8 for them. I didn't notice this. It's got some wear in the thigh area. And these are artists, American Eagle artists. I can't really show you that good, but when I can find them for $2, when I can find American Eagle for $2, I'll sell them all day long. $14, $15, I'll do that. And here's another pair of artists. These are more of a medium wash than a dark wash. Show you here, which artists. Nothing special, guys. These are not home run hits, but for $2, sell them for $14, I'll do those sales all day. These ones I thought, oh, nope, I think there's one more pair of American Eagles sitting over here. Or they are, nope, these are Maurice's. But they're a flare leg. Flare leg. I thought that said made in Hong Kong. That would have been vintage. It doesn't say. But I picked these up also for $2. I usually, if I seen these flare leg Maurice's in the thrift store for $6, I'd walk by them. But for $2, I can make something on them. These I picked up for $5 a piece. These are new women's Levi 550s. I'm assuming from the 80s. You can tell by the tag. The tag's that dark maroon tag. Maybe the early 90s, right? These are Levi 550 relaxed fit tapered, size 14 long. I've sold a lot of these. They're a dark wash. They're new. They don't have the tags, but they're new. And I bought two of them. So keep on moving on. We didn't get a lot of items. They didn't have a lot of clothes. There's a lot of different vendors. Some of you guys would have had a heyday, especially some of you that sell toys and everything like that. You all would have had a heyday in here. And these are another pair of them 550 relaxed tapers. I figure at least 24 to 30 on each one of them. New pair of polo. There's some dinge on them. They're U.S. Polo Assassin, though. They're not worth a lot, but I paid $1.50 for them. Cargo pants or shorts. A pair of O'Neill. Pair of O'Neill's shorts. Oh, MSRP says 55. Of course, we're not going to get 55. They're new. They're the hybrid O'Neill's. I paid $2.50 for them. I thought that was a super good steal. These are Land's End. They look vintage. They're pleated. Wrinkle resistant. No, they're probably not vintage if they say that. I haven't even looked at these guys other than now. When I brought them home is when I looked at them the most. Right here with you guys. Yeah, these are made in China. They do look like the tags look almost vintage, but I don't think they are. Hitted comfort waist. Just some LL Beans pleated chino shorts. Picked those up as well for $1.50. I think I made out on them. Now, we got a bunch of free stuff too. I told you, ladies and gentlemen, about the declutter that actually, the declutter friend that we have that actually got us into decluttering, and she hands us the majority of our jobs, right? She let me stop by and get some free things. I'm not going to go through all that stuff. I haven't even looked at it yet, but you know, the first thing I seen was J. Crew flats. Those will sell for sure. Be able to get rid of them really quick. I did see a Ralph Lauren shoebox, but I can't find them. There's a different pair of shoes in there, and there's these kind of cool floral pants. They're almost like a jegging. They're stretchy. No brand, but they're floral. They're boot cut, flare leg. I don't know if you can see them. So, you know, $8, $9, maybe-ish, and those will sell. But I haven't went through them yet. Okay, now on to the cool stuff, all right? That was my stuff and my niche. In my niche. Look, is it niche? Is it niche? Is it, what is it, right? I don't know. People say it all different. They kind of try to make it sound cool. It's just whatever you usually sell, right? Okay. So, I don't know what I want to show you first, because there's a few cool items. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rare items. I thought this is an action-packed JPL Sojourner Mars Rover Hot Wheels from 1996. Now, I don't know if this has any value. Again, guys, I couldn't look this up on my phone because the reception was blocked or something. Nobody could use their phone inside the school. It's crazy. So I couldn't look it up, but I thought it was pretty cool to give you guys a peek in there. This guy, I also got his business card. He had 3 or 4 8x4 foot tables loaded with Hot Wheel cars. So I took his number just in case. But I did find a rare. This is the 2004 Rebel Rods Hot Wheel. You see, that's different. But it's got the little red walls on the tires. And they're actually rubber tires. But you're not going to be able to see that in my camera if you can't see the red on there. Oh, yeah, you can see the red wall right there. The red wall, and they're actually real rubber tires. And this is it's a limited edition one of 20,000. So they made 20,000 of these. I think that's quite a bit. But who knows? I don't know. I remember Victor told me to look out for the one with the red walls on the wheels. And these ones definitely have the red walls. So I thought that was a pretty cool rare find. And I got another red wall one. He had about 6 to 10 red walls. I didn't know which ones to look out for. This is a 67 GTO. This one is a 2002 one. It does have the red walls, and they are real rubber tires. The real rubber tires, not the plastic ones. So I thought that was a cool find. Vic, if you know about these, let me know, brother. I'm going to do my research on them, see what I can do, but I thought them were cool finds. Last but not least, I paid $2 for this. I thought this was a cool comic. It might not be worth nothing, guys. I just seen Superman, so I thought it was pretty interesting, and I'm trying to look for a year. He said 1970-something. I don't see one, but I picked it up for $2. Pretty cool. It's in really good condition. Wait a minute, does it say right here? C49321. Nope. It don't, and I don't really want to open it. Let me see if I can, if it's got a resealable thing, sealable thing. It does. Let's open it up and see what year it is. It's in good condition. It's got this on the back. I don't know much about comics, right? But I know there's Superman fans, and I know, you know, there's Batman fans, things of that nature, and older comics sometimes hold value, so I picked it up. I want to say he said 70-something. 1976. This is a 1976 comic. Pretty good condition, if you ask me. You guys, if you guys have info on this, let me know. Kind of smells like basement. Is that common? Is it common for comics to smell like a basement? It smells like a Michigan basement. I was just complaining about a Michigan basement, right? It's a pain in the butt. So our plan on that, so I don't have to do that anymore, is get the garage. Oh no. Let's get the garage cleaned out really good, and then move a lot of my inventory out to the garage. Plus, it'll give me more workspace down there. I was talking about that yesterday, I believe. So these are also rare. I seen them on, these are like serial, I forget what they called them, serial advertisement or whatever, or they were in the middle of a comic book. I thought they were pretty rare, though. He said they're pretty rare. It does have the date on them, and I'll fold them out for you guys. I'll pull each one out. I only seen the one. I seen this one on eBay for $40. I seen this one on eBay for $40. It's stamped in the bottom, 1978, made in the USA. It's in really good condition, other than it was obviously creased. It was felt folded in half. But there's no stains on it, no tears. Looks good. Paid $5 for it. So, you know, sell it for 40. This one, I have not seen this one on there. I don't know what this one's going to sell for. This one is a 1979. That one's 1979. That's got Batman and Robin in it. I thought that was pretty cool. If any of you collectors out there are interested in this, message me. Let me know. I'm going to actually list them tonight, though, along with the rest. So, yeah, it kind of sucked because my whole intention today was to shoot a video of us picking. I've never been able to do that. My whole intention was to shoot a video in this school, and it would have been a lot easier to do in there because I don't think they would have cared, for one, but nobody had cell phone service. And with that came a pain in the ass because I didn't know the value of items. I took a gamble on these. As soon as I got out, I looked them up. I seen one would sell for $40. I'm like, well, I got my money back. I got more than my money back, right, off one. So I'd imagine I could either sell them together or I could sell them individually. So that was the finds today, other than this. I have a bag of stuff. I thought this was pretty cool. It's a purse. It was in there. It's a cigar box purse. You know, it's made in China, though, so I'd imagine it's not vintage or nothing like that, but I thought it was pretty cool. I'm sure somebody will buy that for $10. It says Choice Made Cigars. It's got a little latch on it. This was from Holly. Holly is awesome. She's a good friend of ours. Again, she hands us decluttering jobs, and if she gets a lot of she declutters a house, and there's a lot of clothes in there, we get that, right? She calls us up, lets us make a bid on it first, even when she has estate sales, and she's doing it for somebody, and they're trying to sell the clothing and stuff. She'll call us and let us come and check it out first, which is awesome. I think it's very important to network. It's so important to network and know people when you're a reseller. Because the more fish you have in the sea looking for items for you, the more items you're going to have, and the cheaper you're going to find them, and the better odds you're going to have to be able to meet your quota each and every single day, right? So our day was pretty exciting. Like I said, ladies, I haven't looked through this stuff. Sweater Works. Actually, that's kind of actually type of vintage stuff I sell, really. I do sell stuff like that. So that's cool. But Holly always looks out for us. She's super rad. Here's a couple Hollister shirts, some Henleys. Those will sell for $10. Some Hollister Henleys. These were stuck in there. Another one. This one ain't a Henley. This feels like a regular t-shirt. I don't think you get much more than $5 for that. Maybe $6-$7. We'll go through this real quick before I wrap this video up. Because I got to get to work. I did not expect the water flow in the basement. Another Hollister shirt. somebody smoked cigarettes. I quit smoking cigarettes a month ago. And now I can smell what I used to smell like when somebody used to smoke. That's just a Savage shirt. It's actually kind of cool, though. It's Where's Waldo. Somebody might be interested in that. Not for much, though. But that is not me complaining whatsoever. I love free stuff. The Quiet Life. Never even heard of that. This is made in Mexico. 100% cotton. This actually might be vintage. Made in Mexico. The Quiet Life with Snail. Let's see. We'll go through this one bag just to see what's in this find. This is a no brand, or the tag is removed. It kind of looks like something Ralph Lauren would make, though. I sell a lot of Ralph Lauren, but I can't tell because it's missing the tags. Never know. What if I came across, like, the most expensive item I've ever listed in this bag? This is an Ariel t-shirt. This is something I usually would, like, I would only list if I didn't have anything. But that is not me discrediting. That's not me discrediting Holly. I'm like, she said she don't know if anything's in there. If you're in the area, pick this up. Here's a polo shirt that'll sell with the pocket. Not for much though. But these are $6 to $8 sales when they're free. I'll list another polo shirt with the front pocket. See, already at least $20-$30 in this one bag of free stuff. And another polo shirt. These might... No, made in Indonesia. Indonesia, another polo shirt. So that's the one bag. There's one more item. I don't know what this is. Hollister. Hollister shirt. With a front pocket. You know, those are types of items. Like, if I had absolutely nothing, I would probably list for a backup or for a filler. You know, I think that's important, too. Like, you're not going to find... In the beginning, or sometimes you're not going to find all items that can sell for $30, or you're not going to find all items that can sell for $20 and up, right? So a lot of times I'll list 10 of them a day that'll sell for $20 and above, and the next 15 to 20 of them, or the next 10 to 15 of them, will be filler items, $8 items to $15 items. It's good to do that. I do that a lot, but if I'm interested in this. I'm curious in this little Mars rover thing, if anybody knows anything about this. It is from, like I said, 1996. Rover mission to Mars. It might not be worth a penny, but I didn't pay much for it. I only paid $5 for it. So if it don't sell, it don't sell. So that was our day today. I said I was going to make a follow-up video. And now I'm going to get to work. But it... My whole opinion on this whole flea market deal, it was cool, but I don't like it when I can't use my phone. I have better odds in a thrift store because I don't have enough knowledge in everything because I zeroed down in on clothes. So I don't have enough knowledge in this to buy the whole lot the guy had, right? I might have been throwing a lot of money away. I could have been making a lot of money. I don't know. I probably should have bought the rest of the red. They call them the red line wheels or whatever they call them, right? Red walls, Hot Wheel cars. But again, I don't know enough. Am I going to buy all of them and only two of them would have sold? That Hot Wheels was sick. There's a lot of money in the Hot Wheels. Like it a lot, bro. Thanks, man. This one, like I said, this one B is from 2002. It's not that old. This one's for 1996. The Rover to Mars. And this one is from 2004. But the red wall ones, that dude, this is Brandon, commented on the Facebook group for you on YouTube. You just hear me thinking I'm talking to somebody that ain't here. This content also goes on Facebook. So I know a buddy of mine that sells the Hot Wheels, and he says, look out for the red walls. If you can find the red walls, there's something special. So, or people are seeking after them. Right now, there's something special. So that was my find today. Tell me what you guys think this will sell. If you've ever seen this, 1976 Superman. It actually says Superboy and the Legion of Superheroes. It don't even say Superman. This was before he was Superman. Look at that. It says Superboy. It don't say Superman. Was Superman really called Superboy before Superman? Brandon said the Rover's going for $25 on eBay. That's awesome. I only paid $5 on it. That means I made a profit on that already. Thanks, brother. I appreciate you looking that up. That's cool. I'm cool with the $20, well, it's not profit after you take taxes and shit out, but it's still a profitable item, so I didn't lose on that. I didn't know Superman was called Superboy in 1976. Look at that. Superboy. That's something cool. All you comic nerds and geeks, fill me in on some information about when Superboy became Superman. All right? Thanks, everybody, for watching. Stay tuned to the next one tomorrow. Or, no, I don't got the time to make another one later on this afternoon. So tell me what you guys think of the video. If you got something from it, please share the content. For all those of you that have shared the content, I appreciate it. Like it, dislike it. It's your boy, Flippinstoop, and I'm out.